Good morning, Everyday Math. First off, here is our joke for the day. So here it is. What did the shoemaker say to the cat when he walked into his shop? Shoe! There it is. All right. We are on page 328 on your math journal. In your math journal, not really on it. So please turn to that page. You will need to do that to help you with this problem. So here is what the distributive property actually looks like. So at the top, you've got this chart right here. Come on, draw. There it is. Finally showed up. Chart right there. And we're talking about multiplying over addition and then multiplying over subtraction. So I'm going to show you, I'm going to kind of copy what this chart means on the writing on the right side. And we'll get this going again. So what we have here is that we are multiplying something inside parentheses. So here's what it looks like. So they're saying that we have a times x plus y. And what that really means is that we have to multiply a times x plus, which is our sign right here, plus a times y. This is called the distributive property. We are distributing a to both variables inside. Distribute means to give out. So you're giving out a to both x and y. So what the problem really means, it's a times x plus a times y. And the same thing is true with subtraction. If you have a times x minus y, all you do is simply change this to a minus sign. So we have a times x minus a times y. All right, that's really the distributive property. Very simple enough. It looks really easy when you know both of the numbers that are inside. If you know x and y, the problem's really easy. However, when you get into algebra, it is really, really important. But we're going to stick to just our numbers first. So looking at number one, we have 4 times 70 plus 8. So what it says use the distributive property to fill in the blanks. So I need to multiply 4 times 70, and I also need to multiply 4 times 8. And I add those together, and I would get the answer. Okay, so that's kind of what you're going today on your worksheets. You're going to be filling in the numbers that are needed for the distributive property. So we're really writing it out long ways to really help you understand this property. So for example, if I were going to write 5 times 2 minus 8, what that really means is 5 times 2 minus sign times 5 times 8. That's how we really solved the problem. Any questions? Obviously, if you can't, I don't know why I just said that, because I'm talking to a whiteboard. But if you have questions with this concept, please raise your hand. And I will gladly help you out. Okay. Fill in the blanks. Work on the problems. You got questions? Ask for help. This was a pretty short video. And I will see you in real life.